Hallelujah. Good morning, friends. Nice to be in your space again. It's another week. This is the last full week of June. June is going to end on the 30th. That is Tuesday next week. So this is the last full week of June, and I believe God for you that it's going to be a time of refreshing. Whatever God has invested for you for June, it shall drop on your feet, on your laps this week in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. We appreciate your faithfulness. Thank you for always being there. Thank you for keeping us from the pestilence and from all evil intentions. Daddy, we are grateful. It's another week that we commit this week to everyone. Please have your way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Sweethearts, let's worship God together.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power.
Power. Chapter 13. If you read from verse 14 to 17, you will hear Jesus giving us example about power of service. Recently, banks were declaring their profit for the first quarter of 2020. And all service providers, I look at service providers, their profit is ever bigger than manufacturing companies. Service providers, they do little energy, little activity, but manufacturers do so much activity. No wonder it is not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth. It's God that showeth mercy. May God show you mercy.
Amen.
Jesus showed us there. He washed the feet of the disciples and told them, if you want to lead, you must provide service. Till tomorrow, service providers control the world. They make much interest, much profit. They are always ahead, and there's less noise compared to the manufacturing company producers of goods and service. Service providers are ever ahead. The Bible recalled in Job 36 from verse 10. Job 36 from verse 10. It says, if you serve me and obey me. So serving God, serving men, and obeying the rules and laws that govern business always yield increase. Always yield results. Say, if you serve me and obey me, say, you will spend your days in prosperity and your years in pleasure. No wonder service providers make more, get more. If you're a service provider, at the end of the day, you are better than those that are involved in other activities. The same thing in the spiritual realm, brothers and sisters. People that serve are always blessed. Jesus said, it's more blessed to give than to receive. It's more blessed to give your service. It's more blessed to give. Everyone that provides service, they are always better off. There's so much power in service. Jesus told us in John chapter 15, he said, if you obey me and serve, whatever you ask the Father in my name, I will do it. John 15, 14 to 16. He said, I'm calling you my friends. I'm no longer calling you my servants. Beloved brethren, I want to challenge you. Can you imagine if there was no one to provide the kind of service that you enjoy daily? Can you imagine what you can provide for homes? Can you imagine what you can do? Enough of just being waiting for others to create the job and you go apply. You too can create employment for others. And you'll be surprised the stuff that you have made up. The Lord is clear about it. He said, go and be fruitful. Beloved, I want you to think about it. Offer service. Touch a life. Minister something good to someone that needs it around you. And you see the return on investment. I'll see you tomorrow, my God grace. There's power in serving. And all those that serve, they are always on top. God bless you.
Amen.
Jesus, I see him moving on your behalf this week.
Amen.
I see him accruing all that he has ordained for you for June unto you this week.
Amen.
As you go in the power of the Holy Ghost this week, I will hear your testimony.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
See you tomorrow.